بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، brothers and sisters, inshallah ta'ala, what we want to quickly discuss in this video is the concept of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being hazir nazir, يعني omnipresent. Is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam someone that knows the unseen? Does he know the ilm al-ghayb? And inshallah ta'ala, because it's a concept that has afflicted many, we want to quickly address it with the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Firstly, brothers and sisters, we need to understand the issue of the ghayb. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned all these ayat, that only He knows the ilm al-ghayb. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, قُلْ لَا أَمْلِكُ لِنَفْسِي نَفْعًا وَلَا ضَرًّا إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ. Say to them, O Muhammad, I do not have any ownership of any benefit nor harm. وَلَوْ كُنْتُ أَعْلَمُ الْغَيْبِ لَاسْتَكْثَرْتُ مِنَ الْخَيْرِ. If I knew the unseen, I would have been excessive in trying to obtain goodness. This is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Azza wa Jalla is telling him, say, O Muhammad, that if you knew the ghaib, then you would have done this. And it has come in many other verses as well, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, say to them, O Muhammad, قُلْ لَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ عِنْدِي خَزَائِنُ اللَّهِ. Say to them, O Muhammad, that you do not have the treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا أَعْلَمُ الْغَيْبِ, and I do not know the unseen. Rather, this comes twice in the Quran with similar words in another verse in Surah Hud, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, قُلْ لَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ عِنْدِي خَزَائِنُ اللَّهِ وَلَا أَعْلَمُ الْغَيْبِ. Not only once was it mentioned, rather Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say it twice. And there's emphasis on the matter now. And also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, وَعِنْدُهُ مَفَاتِحُ الْغَيْبِ لَا يَعْلَمُهَا إِلَّا هُوَ. And only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the keys of the unseen. Nobody knows it except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there's many ayat that we can bring in regards to this matter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, قُلْ لَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ الْغَيْبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Say to them, O Muhammad, that nobody knows the unseen in the heavens and the earth except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers and sisters, if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was really hazir nazir, then why would he ask some questions in trying to find things out? As we're going to be mentioning now a few examples to make this matter more clear. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one time went to Al-Medina, as it came in the narration of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him and his father as well. قدم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى المدينة. He headed towards المدينة. فرأى اليهود تصوم يوم عاشوراء. He saw the Jews fasting on the day of Ashura. He asked the question, ما هذا? What is this? If the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم knew the unseen and he was حاضر ناظر, يعني حاضر الناظر, then why would you ask this question? Doesn't it only make sense that the Prophet ﷺ would know automatically and he would tell his companions after that to do something else if there was a need? So they said, قَالُوا هَذَا يَوْمٌ صَالِحٌ نَجَى اللَّهُ فِيهِ مُوسَى وَبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. This is a great day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Musa and Bani Israel مِنْ عَدُوِهِمْ, from the enemy, يعني فرعون. فصامه, so they fasted. So Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام fasted. فقال أنا أحق بموسى منكم. I have more of a right with Musa than you lot. فصامه وأمر بصيامه. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم fasted it and he commanded the people to fast as well. The point that I'm trying to get across here, brothers and sisters, is the fact that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked the question, ما هذا? What is this? And it came in another narration that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, a man came to him and he said to him, إني نظرت أن أنحر إبلا ببوانا. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi and he said to him, Ya Rasulullah, I have made an oath that I'm going to slaughter in a place called Buwana. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got suspicious. Why Buwana? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him two questions. And this is the point. To prove to you that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not Hazir, Nazir. The first question that he asked him, هَلْ كَانَ فِيهَا وَثْنٌ مِنْ أَوْثَانِ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ يُعْبَدْ. In this place that you're talking about, did the polytheists used to worship their idols in the specific place that you're claiming? The man said no. The second question that he asked him, هَلْ كَانَ فِيهِ عِيدٌ مِنْ عَيَادِهِمْ. Did they used to have their celebrations in this place that you're speaking about? The man said no. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, أوفي بنظرك. Fulfill your oath. The point is, why would the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ask these two questions? If he was Hazir Nazir and he knew the ilm al-ghayb, which is specifically for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the last hadith bi-idhnillahi ta'ala that I want to mention is the hadith of Sahl ibn Sa'din radiyallahu an. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنِّي فَرَطُكُمْ عَلَى الْحَوْضِ. I will meet you at the hawd. مَنْ مَرَّ عَلَيَّ شَرِبَ. And whoever comes past me, he will drink from the hawd. وَمَنْ شَرِبَ لَمْ يَضْمَ بَعْدَهُ أَبَدًا. And whoever drinks from it will never ever be thirsty again. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make me and all of you that are listening from those that drink from the hawd. لَيَرِدَنَّ عَلَيَّ أَقْوَامٌ أَعْرِفُهُمْ يَعْرِفُونَنِي. So people will come that I know and that you don't know as well. ثُمَّ يُحَالُ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَهُمْ. Then there will be a barrier that's put between me and them. فَأَقُولُ إِنَّهُمْ مِنِّي. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will say that you lot are from me. He will say that these people now, that there has been a barrier put between himself and the people, he will say they are from my people. إِنَّهُمْ مِنِّي. And it came in some other narrations, أُمَّتِي أُمَّتِي, my people, my people. فَيُقَالُ, it will be said to him, إِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي مَا أَحْدَثُ بَعْدَكَ. You do not know that which they innovated and did after you. So if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was Hazir Nazir, then he would already automatically know that these people did innovation. They changed after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had passed away. And he would have said, Ummati, Ummati, my people, my people. Brothers and sisters, it's important that we rectify our aqeedah. A person, he can be the biggest faqih in the world. He can know a hadith, memorize it inside out, whether it's Bukhari, whether it is Muslim. He can know the arba'at madahib, the madhab of Imam al-Shafi'i, Imam Malik, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Ahmed. He can have the madahib on smash, know his fiqh inside out. But if one concept of his belief is all watery and his belief is not rectified, wallahi, all of these matters will not benefit him. That's why the ulama, they say, العقيدة أولا لو كانوا يعلمون. The عقيدة should come first if only they knew. And inshallah ta'ala, I will conclude with this narration of Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله عنه, when he said, والذي نفسي ابن عمر بيده. He swore by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لو أن لأحدكم مثل أحد ذهبا ثم أنفقه في سبيل الله. If any of you lot had like the mountain of Uhud in gold, ثم أنفقه في سبيله. And then he spent it in charity. Brothers and sisters, it takes hours and hours to climb the mountain of Uhud. Maybe it is equivalent to billions, hundreds of billions of pounds. If you was to get the gold the size of Uhud and maybe convert it to pounds or dollars, it would be in its billions. This man takes it and he spends it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَا قَبِلَ اللَّهُ مِنْهُ حَتَّى يُؤْمِنَ بِالْقَدَرِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept from him until he believes in the qadar. Brothers and sisters, the issue of al-qadar is one aspect from the many aspects that one needs to believe in. It is a pillar from the six pillars of al-iman. If you don't just believe in one, then nothing will be accepted from you. So us rectifying our belief, just believing that Allah, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is hazir nazir, that he knows the unseen, which goes against all these ayah that we just mentioned. Brothers and sisters, it is dangerous. It is important that we rectify our belief and know this. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who act upon that which they hear and make this a wujurun jariyah, a continuous reward. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, من دعا إلى الهدى كان له أجر مثل من تبعه لا ينقص ذلك من أجوره شيئا. Whoever calls the guidance, for him is the reward for everybody that does it and everyone that follows him upon it. And he won't take anything away from his reward. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.